A feature that is notably absent here is liver aminotransferases, which have not been found to have predictive value in NAFLD. On the contrary, because serum ALT can be normal in up to 60% of patients with NASH, increased ALT cannot be used to predict progression to NASH. NAFLD is generally a silent disease. While a minority of patients will have intermittent right upper quadrant discomfort, fullness, or fatigue, most will have no symptoms. So most patients are unaware that they are at risk for NASH and its consequences. This is not that dissimilar from hypertension, where you have to test for it to find it and then treat it. The condition is usually found incidentally on imaging when patient undergoes testing for an unrelated symptom or condition or has liver enzymes checked for unrelated reasons. One of the main reasons NASH is underdiagnosed is that a liver biopsy is required to confirm the diagnosis. But liver biopsy is far from a perfect diagnostic tool. It is invasive, it is costly, it is potentially risky and painful, and may understage liver disease severity. Because of the pitfalls of liver biopsy, non-invasive testing for steatohepatitis and fibrosis are being developed and refined as alternatives for diagnosing NASH and NASH at risk of progression to cirrhosis in patients with NAFLD, and also staging the severity of fibrosis. Both clinical tests that rely on demographic data and blood tests and imaging techniques such as elastography, both ultrasound and MRI based, are being studied alone and in combination. International collaborative efforts combining academia, industry, and regulatory agencies are working diligently to find appropriate non-invasive tests to replace liver biopsy in routine clinical practice. One specific clinical test that is being developed by the French biotech company Genfit has identified 5 key predictive parameters to find patients with pre-cirrhotic NASH who are at risk of progression. These are patients who have NASH, but have had an NAFLD activity score of 4 or more, and a fibrosis stage equal to 2 or 3. This panel includes innovative microRNAs. A new algorithm incorporating these 5 parameters has been shown to identify patients who must be treated with a good level of accuracy. That is, an area under the curve score of 0.82. According to recommendations of regulatory agencies, the phase 3 programs are currently targeting this patient population for treatment. With this algorithm, GenFit is helping the community to address a highly relevant question. Further studies are needed, however, before this test is ready for everyday clinical use. In addition to non-invasive testing on the horizon, it is critical that we increase awareness of fatty liver disease across other medical specialties, as hepatologists cannot find and treat all of the patients who have this condition. That means diabetologists, endocrinologists, cardiologists, and even general practitioners should all be aware of NASH and its untoward consequences if left untreated. These providers should also be aware of future therapies that are currently under evaluation today, because ultimately they will all play a key role in identifying, treating, and referring patients with advanced disease to the hepatologist so that all of the population with the disease can be managed in a proper and efficient way.